एवरीवन, टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोटेक्शन इन सोनेट एसडीएच। माय नेम इज धीरज पांडे, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। दीज आर द कंटेंट। फर्स्ट वन इज इंट्रोडक्शन, पॉइंट टू पॉइंट लिंक, सेल्फ हीलिंग रिंग, बाइडायरेक्शनल पाथ स्विच रिंग, बाइडायरेक्शनल लाइन स्विच रिंग, रिंग इंटरकनेक्शन, इंटरकनेक्शन एंड डुअल होमिंग एंड रेफरेंसेस। सो इंट्रोडक्शन, अ मेजर अकम्प्लिशमेंट ऑफ सोनेट एंड एसडीएच नेटवर्क डेवलपमेंट डिप्लॉयमेंट वॉज टू प्रोवाइड अ सिग्निफिकेंट इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द अवेलेबिलिटी एंड रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ द ओवरऑल नेटवर्क। दिस वॉज डन थ्रू द यूज ऑफ extensive set of protection techniques for both sonet and sdh। same schemes are used but their nomenclature is a bit different, okay? so different type of links that are used, first one is point to point link। in case of point to point link, two fundamental type of protection mechanism are used। that first one is called 1+1 protection। in case of 1+1 protection, traffic is transmitted simultaneously on two separate fibers, okay? as you can see here, data is transmitted separately over two paths, okay? as this technique is very fast and requires no signaling protocol between the two ends। and second mechanism is 1:1 or sometimes 1:n protection। in case of 1:1 protection, traffic is transmitted over only one fiber at a time, okay? at a time only one fiber is in working state, another is in protection, another will be remain for protection type, so only at a time। so in this case signaling protocol is required and APS signaling protocol is required between the source and destination। this type of technique is not quick as 1+1 protection technique, okay? so these are the diagram how it works। in case of 1+1 protection technique, both the channels, all channels used simultaneously over two paths, as signal is simultaneously transmitted over two paths। but in case of 1:1 protection, signal is transmitted over a working path under normal condition, but if there is any failure, then protection fiber path is used। what are the advantages of 1:1 protection? that under normal operation, the protection fiber is unused, therefore it can be used to transmit low priority traffic। this low priority traffic must be discarded if the working fiber is cut। and another advantage is the 1:1 protection can be extended so as to share a single protection fiber among many working fibers। as we can see here, a single protection fiber can be shared by n number of fibers, okay, n number of sources or destinations। so in case of any failure, the protection path can be used, 1:1 protection, in which is a more generalized form of 1:1 protection where n working paths share a single protection path. Okay. Now next come to self-healing ring. Ring networks have become very popular in the career worlds as well as in enterprise networks. A ring is a simplest topology that is two connected, that is provide two separate paths between any pair of nodes that do not have any nodes or links in common except the source and destination nodes. And this allow our ring networks to be resilient to failure. Rings are also efficient from the fiber layout perspective. Multiple sites can be interconnected with a single physical ring. Okay. Now, as we are talking about SONET SDH, much of the carrier infrastructure today use SONET SDH rings. These rings are called self-healing. Why we call this self-healing? Because they incorporate protection mechanism that automatically detect failure and reroute traffic away from failed link and nodes onto other route traffic. The links are implemented using SONET SDH add drop multiplexer. These are type of self-healing rings. First one is a unidirectional path switching ring. In case of unidirectional path switching ring, carriers working traffic in only one direction. Okay. The different type of ring architecture differs in two aspects, in the directionality of traffic and in the protection mechanism used. So in unidirectional path switched ring, one of the fiber is considered the working fiber and other is protection fiber. Traffic is transmitted simultaneously on the working fiber in the clockwise direction and the protection fiber in the counterclockwise direction. Protection is done at the path layer. Okay. Next one is bidirectional line switch ring. Here shown a 4 fiber bidirectional line switch ring. We call it BLSR4. In this, carrier working traffic is in both directions. The ring has two working fibers and two protection fibers. Traffic between two nodes is transmitted normally on the shortest path between them. And either span or ring switching is used to restore service after a failure. Okay. Next, there is a unidirectional path switch ring that we talk about that in next lecture. Okay.